song Lifeboat is probably the most satirical song I've ever written, and it kind of takes a situation to an extreme. When I was growing up, we used to play in public schools this game called Lifeboat, where the teacher would come in and she would say that today we're going to play a game, a big ship has just sunk, and there's five people in this lifeboat, but the lifeboat only really has room for two people, so you class decide which three are going to be thrown overboard. And so we did this song and a video of the song, and I play the teacher and the class decides who's going to be thrown overboard, and while they're at it, they decide that maybe they don't like this teacher so much either.
And finally tonight, this report from Channel 7's Don Wilson on the controversy surrounding a new game being played in public elementary schools.
You won't find it on the playground. You'll find it in the classroom. The game is called Lifeboat, and in it, the teacher has the school children decide themselves who will be tossed out of an overcrowded lifeboat in order to ensure the survival of the fittest. The game, however, has generated some controversy in communities like this one, where parents are concerned that their children may have taken lifeboat a little too far.
I was away from the house, getting my nails done just like any other Saturday morning. When I come home, I find Ashley's lettuce patch dolls in the bottom of the pool, with bricks tied to their little legs. I mean, do you have any idea how expensive these dolls are? Or how long I had to stand in line to get one?
I'm concerned that we're creating power delusions in our children at a very young age. After all, 8 and 9-year-olds are far too immature to be making life and death decisions. And of course, there is that subliminal pressure to be perfect, to be a superior member of our society, so as not to be thrown out of the boat, as it were.
Are you watching this?
It is my hope that today...
Are you believing this? Steve, babe, this is it. We're talking, you have got your finger on the pulse of today's record-buying youth. You tune Lifeboat, it's going to take us to the top. I'm not talking halfway. I'm not talking three quarters. I'm talking El Capitan. Yo comprende vous, huh? I can see it. I mean, I can tell you I can see it. I see the gold. I see the platinum. I see a lot of precious metal.
Look, I already said it was Bose Wiper from the album cover, but this is out of the question.
Steve, babe, buddy, pal, hombre, huh? Who are you talking to? It's me, Chuck, your manager. I love you more than my own brother. I am not going to stand in front of a camera looking... What is this? Am I robbing a bank? I'm not going to stand in front of a camera looking like a school mom. I don't have the legs for this.
Good morning, class.
Good morning, Mrs. Harriet.
Today we're going to play a game. This game is called Lifeboat. All together?
Lifeboat!
Good! Lifeboat is a lesson in values clarification. Can you say values clarification?
No!
Values clarification is where your little minds decide which lives are worth living and which lives are worth not living. Now, here's how we play. The big ship just sank. There are 5 people on the lifeboat, but the lifeboat is only made for 2. I'll list the 5 people on the chalkboard, and you, class, will decide which 3 will be thrown overboard. Are we ready?
Yes, Mrs. Harriet.
Good! First, there's an old, crippled grandfather. Second, there's a mentally handicapped person in a wheelchair.
What's mentally handicapped?
It means they can never be a productive member of society. Thirdly, there's an overweight woman on welfare with a sniffling, whimpering baby.
It's a baby on welfare, too.
Let's not push this, sir.
Who else is in the boat?
A young white cargo with blue eyes and perfect teeth, and Joan Collins. Now, class, take 5 minutes to make your decision. Time's up. Well, class?
Go on, work that clock, cause she's getting pretty old. Go out now, baby, or we'll all be catching its cold. Go over, Granny, and we'll see if she can float. Go out the meantime, and they won't be rocking the boat.
Very good! That was fun, wasn't it? Next lesson, we're going to do an experiment.
Yay!
are going to test the law of gravity, just like Galileo, by dropping two objects out the window, one day and one light, to test which one hits the sidewalk first. Now what shall we use for the lighter object? I'm thinking of something small and square.
An eraser?
Good! And what shall we use for the honey object? I'm thinking of something round and dusty. Mommy, I haven't given you permission to make dusty.
Quas,
the ball is not long. What do you think? Oh, Quas, put me down. Quas, put me down this instant. What are you?